I think partly my introduction would come through as the story progresses of our life and work in Gadchiroli. So I shall currently not go with the formal introduction, but the story of search in Gadchiroli. The story began, as rightly pointed out, again as with Mahatma Gandhi. This is Bapu Kuti in Sevagram Ashram, where Gandhiji spent his last 13 years. 1946, one morning, one young professor of economics and law who had set a gold medal record in University of Nagpur entered the room of Mahatma Gandhi. He was sitting on the mud-covered floor of his Bapu Kuti. This young man had also joined Quit India movement, was in jail for 2 years, had broken the jail, was put in isolation, has been considered a hero, and was appointed as the national professor of economics by Mahatma Gandhi himself. And he had an offer letter from Texas University for pursuing his PhD in economics, and with the promise to come back to India and join subsequently the growth of modern India and its finances. So he went to meet the Mahatma and asked for his blessings. Mahatma Gandhi, of course, knew him. He told him, "Bataiye, Professor Thakur Das ji, kaise aana kiya?" He informed him that such is the case, I am going to US to pursue my further education. And Gandhiji looked at him for a few seconds and then just uttered a single sentence. "Arthashastra sikhna hai, to America ki jagah Bharat ke dehaton mein jao." Thakur Das ji, my grandfather, came out, tore away his passport, visa, scholarship papers, was recently married with one young kid, and straight away with his students of economics and law and commerce, went to live like a farmer in a village nearby, again Sevagram Ashram, working like a farmer, living on the finances generated by the farmer of Vidarbha, whom we read almost daily in newspaper, committing suicide and surviving on that. And continued his journey with both Mahatma Gandhi, subsequently Vinoba, in the Bhudan movement, Jayaprakash, in the Sampurna Kranti, throughout his life. Inspired by his own life and, of course, the message of Gandhi, my parents, after coming back to India, had this mission, how to provide accessible and affordable healthcare to rural and tribal people, and importantly, how to use science and technology for that. Now, contrary to many beliefs, and there I must say that I completely agree with Sudhindra ji, Gandhi was a man of science. His autobiography is called My Experiments with Truth, not My Story of Truth or My Life Journey, etc. So he was a man of science. So how to use science? So search was established. And the first question that, of course, anyone faces when we start our work, set up an organization, was where to start the work. And formally, the message of Gandhi was quite prominent still. And we decided that the principle we would be following would be go where the problems are and not where you are a problem. So we decided Gadchiroli would be the ideal place where we won't be a problem and where all the problems are, 1,000 kilometers to the east of this place and 100 years behind this place. Heavily forested, this is the ancient Dandakaran forest of India. Tribals believe Shabari was one of them and Ram walked through this forest. Rudyard Kipling was a collector around this district, so they also believe that Mowgli was part of this forest. Superstitions, of course, there. Outside any village you go, you would find these gods and goddesses because, well, who would provide healthcare apart from gods and goddesses? The Gond tribe is the most predominant tribal community there, Gond and the Madia community. This was a routine mode of transportation, a bullock cart, in a district which was very widely spread, 400 by 300 kilometers, a large, large district, with such poor infrastructure. This bridge was never completed. This bridge was started 35 years back, still it is incomplete. And such are the rains, so everything gets flooded. And this was Gadchiroli, where the general livelihood was paddy cultivation during monsoon and collection of some food processes and material from the forest, such as this mahua. Now, there's an interesting story about this mahua, which our tribal friends told us when we went to Gadchiroli. They told us that few decades back, government of Maharashtra brought out a GR. The GR said that tribal, brew liquor from Mahua. So cut all the Mahua trees in tribal areas. Forgetting completely that Mahua also serve as a very major source of food during all the months of the year. The second part of the GR was, toad is very nutritious. So cultivate more and more toad trees in Maharashtra because the oil of toad is rich in protein. Tribal told us this story and they started laughing. We asked them, why are you laughing? Then they told us that Mahua is the flower and toad is the fruit of the same tree. And government of Maharashtra came out with this GR, and such is the abysmal understanding of Mantralaya and Mumbai about Gadchiroli, that's why we have left-wing extremism. One of the most severely affected districts in India, especially the block where we live, Dhanora, can be considered the top 10 block affected by violence in the country. And this is where we started our first office. This is the godown of Tendupatta leaves from where BD is made. And currently, we and my colleagues are residing in our campus called Shodgram, spread over 40 acres with 150 of my colleagues. The second question, of course, anyone faces is, what are the health problems of the people where we have started our work and what should we work on? We did not have to wait long. This girl came to the hospital one day. You can see the abdomen was distended. Spleen was very large. She was extremely anemic. And when the blood slide was taken, her RBCs were found to be sickle-shaped. She had classic sickle cell anemia, which is found in tribal in many parts. So we conducted a large district-wide sample study of sickle cell. People came out happily giving their sample, and ultimately the health minister of Maharashtra came down to Gadchiroli, praised search, the district administration, you have done such a wonderful work, found a disease in the tribal, we must do something, and we must set a center for tribal health care. And then few days back, after this story came, that, the minister truly stood with his promise, a tribal healthcare center was set up in Pune. So tribal in Gadchiroli, disease in Gadchiroli, and center was in Pune. So we were completely perplexed, again, very frustrated. We went and asked the tribal, we must agitate against this, your rights are being discouraged. Tribal told us, see doctor, you came to us. We did not tell you that we have this disease. Did we ever complain? No. You came to us as a guest, asked for a few drops of blood. We gave it to you as anybody would give to a guest. So this is your disease and that center is your headache. Go and manage it. That's why we realize this second principle, that research or our work must address the needs of the community and where I work with, and not the research community I report to. My own intellectual itch should not decide the research and work priorities. So of course the question was, how to search such research or work topics, how to find such problems. A very famous saying in malariology, in tropical medicine actually. So Ronald Ross, who was a British doctor in British Army working in India, was working on malaria. And he had this inkling that there must be some link between mosquito and malaria. And he was walking along the streets of London with his teacher, Patrick Manson, the father of tropical medicine, asking, please tell me how I should go ahead. And Patrick Manson offered this sagely advice, my son, if you want to do research on mosquitoes, learn to think like a mosquito. Similarly, if you wanted to work on tribal with them, for them, we must understand how they think. So of course, go to them, meet them in informal settings, understand their issues. We started organizing annual tribal health assembly in our campus, finding out the various problems of people. People would come, showcase their tribal culture, they would find that as their home, and then finally vote as to what their key problems are and what efforts should undertake. For example, one of the key problems was lack of culturally appropriate and friendly hospital care. We asked them, why don't you go to the hospital set up by the government? So they said, number one, these hospitals are multi-storied and we are damn scared to enter such hospitals. Number two, in the hospital, doctor is inside, patient is inside, and relatives are outside. So the patient says, after 10 years, 10 days, I'll die, but I will go out of this hospital and go back to my village. Number three, they said, that you doctors in this hospital speak in such some gitpit language, their word, which we don't understand. Gitpit is English. Number fourth, they said that you doctors and nurses wear white clothes. We asked them, what is your enmity with white clothes? They said, we wrap our dead bodies in white clothes. And finally, they said that in your hospital, there is no God. You doctors have become gods in your hospital, but there is no true God in your hospital. So taking clue from them, we first created temple of goddess Danteshwari. Her idol was brought from Dantewada, which is a known place now, and set up there. A tribal-friendly hospital, which resembles a tribal home in a tribal village. Multiple huts additionally, good quality, where tribal can live with their family, cook their own food. And several surgical specialist OPD care, etc. So we cater to almost 30,000 patients, conducting 700 surgeries every year. We started a mobile medical unit, which would go to the villages and provide health care. And the second problem, they said, was of course malaria. Now, how major this is a disease in Gadchiroli? Just a simple statistics. The population of Gadchiroli district is 1% of the population of entire state of Maharashtra. Vis-a-vis, of the 25% of the Falciparum falciparum cases of malaria occur in Gadchiroli. So 1% population and 25% falciparum malaria cases. Huge burden, their biggest killer. So again, community healthcare program, training tribal healthcare worker, rapid diagnostic kit, rapid treatment, ambulance services, and use of insecticide-treated bed nets, including Sharmdan, to clean up the villages and the pockets of mosquito growth in the tribal villages. The third issue, they said, was women's reproductive health, the various infections of women, reproductive infections, which nobody talks. It is a complete dogma, and nobody wishes to discuss that in our society, especially in the tribal and rural society. And they would just gossip and speak in ears as it would happen. But how big it is an issue psychologically also. So I still remember, we had done a study way back, I was a child, and asked women in Gadchiroli to identify their 10 health needs. They ranked obstructed labor and infertility as the top number one disease for women. So we are perplexed. We asked them, obstructed labor, one can understand. In a disease where emergency obstetric care is not available, obstructed labor would lead to death of the mother and the child. But why infertility? No one dies in infertility. The answer that they gave was stunning. They said that in obstructed labor, a woman dies once. If she is infertile, in our community, she dies daily. So reproductive tract infection and diseases of women's health causing infertility and several other issues were a very major issue voiced by the women. So we then did a study, a sample study for the first time in the world on that in only two villages, which was subsequently published in The Lancet as the study of the decade, which found that 92% of the women in the rural community has one or the other gynecological disease. On an average, each woman had 2.4, more than two diseases. 50% was because of infection, and only 7% had ever received any health care. So huge burden of reproductive health issues in the community identified for the first time. It led to a major shift, especially in the ICPD conference in Cairo, which led to the conclusion that women's health is not mere contraceptives or family planning, but reproductive health of women. Hence, not only maternal child health, but women's and child health, or RCH as it is termed. So major shift. But should we stop at that? So we then turn to this traditional birth attendant present in the community since thousands of years and train them using various non-conventional methods in how to diagnose women's reproductive tract illness and diseases in the community and treat them in the community. And this was the convocation of the first batch of these traditional birth attendants who passed this course and started treating. Also the first TBA in the world who were actually treating RTI in the community. The fourth issue that the people voiced was, of course, child death, that our children die. Now, unfortunately, this issue was not becoming a major social issue per se, an issue to fight for. And the story of Sulabha Chavan, a girl, which my father had the experience to deal with, is something worth recollecting here. Now, Sulabha Chavan was a girl, aged about 9 years, admitted in Medical College Nagpur, when my father was studying as a house officer. And as part of the team of the medical professional, he was the youngest, the junior most, and was entitled with the responsibility to take care of Sulabha. Now, Sulabha's parents were complaining that the complaint of Sulabha, key problem she has, is fever. So she was admitted with fever. So every day her temperature record was being kept in the hospital. Every day doctors would come for a round, and every day they would found that on the temperature record, Sulabha had no fever. So parents were complaining of fever, and the temperature record kept by the nurses showed there was no fever. And the doctors would scold the parents. I mean, you have no business, she has no problem, this is only your illusion, etc. and etc. This went on for 8 days. On the 9th day, Sulabha had severe convulsions and she died. Autopsy was performed. In autopsy, it was found that Sulabha had a disease called miliary tuberculosis, a certain type of tuberculosis in which tuberculosis bacilli is spread not only in the lungs but in the entire body. And the entire body is pitted with various granules of TB bacilli across. And coincidentally, the key complaint in a case of miliary tuberculosis is fever, which is exactly was the complaint of Sulabha and informed by her parents. Everybody was perplexed, and the responsibility fell on my father to find out what is the reason. If that was the complaint, we were not finding fever. When he searched, they found out that the fever was not being recorded because the mercury column of the thermometer of that ward was blocked. So Sulabha had fever daily, but the mercury column was blocked and was not recording fever. This was exactly the state of the society in Maharashtra and the health department, where despite huge burden of child deaths, there was no movement to really take the necessary action apart from statements. So how to sensitize society to the issue? We decided to follow a simple principle, which is sacred in demography. Brian McCarthy's statement: every life counts. So count every birth and account for every death. Count every birth and account for every death. We decided that we would find what is the hidden child mortality in Maharashtra, set up a group called Child Death Study Action Group, and we found that this was the difference in the number and completeness of recording of child deaths in Maharashtra. If the recording by the CDSAG group was 100%, Government of Maharashtra was recording only 20% of the child deaths in Maharashtra. So in reality, there were 200,000 child deaths in Maharashtra in the year 2001. Probably more than in tsunami, were happening in 1 year in one of the most developed state of India every year. This was published as a major report, also published in the Economical Political Weekly, created a stir in Maharashtra. Media took this up as a major issue. Questions were raised in the assembly. And finally, the government moved. And look at this simple result of what is the impact, how many you use data to make such an action. Before Child Death Study Action Group, you can see the stillbirth rate reported in one of the block of Gadchiroli was only 4. And after this focus on complete death recording, it went up to almost 30. Before, the IMR of Gadchiroli was ridiculously stated as 13. Now, I mean, Gadchiroli, if it is as good as Kerala, why does it need to be Gadchiroli of all the districts? After CDSAG published and the focus increased on completeness of child recording, the actual IMR was found to be almost 82. So one simple study, focus on recording every single child death, led to immediate corrective measures by the government and started measurement of the problem correctly, which is the first step towards solution. Now, of course, that was our next step. Why do children die and how to save them? And we decided that if you want to find answer to this question, we must follow our next principle. One accurate measurement is infinitely superior to 1,000 intelligent opinions. Now, we Indians have opinions, famously. And we are very argumentative. We have opinion on everything, from how Barack Obama should set up the financial economy of the world to how what BMC should do. And generally, we are wrong. So we decided that we won't have opinions, we would measure. So we set up what we called a community laboratory of 134 villages in Gadchiroli. And we would find out what is the cause of child death. So we created a new system called verbal autopsy. Now you can imagine very easily, every child who is dying in the villages cannot be brought for formal autopsy in the hospital. So you need to have a different system. So a computerized algorithm was created called verbal autopsy. A community health worker will go and ask questions in a systematic way. Answers would be feed in the computer and the computer will give a cause of death. Verbal autopsy. Without any medical college, any high modern techniques, one can find out what is the cause of death. It was published as a paper in WHO bulletin, and this is what we found. Pneumonia, 20% of child deaths, diarrhea, malaria, immunizable diseases, and neonatal group, child up to the age of 28 days. These were the major killers, and malnutrition was a contributory factor in almost all of these diseases. But those were the biological causes. On the other hand, we found that if one has to trace the journey of a child health, there can be almost 33 causes. Several social causes. You can see poverty, anemia, low birth weight, no breastfeed, diluted milk, superstition, belief system, witchcraft, no ICDS reach, evil eye, illiteracy, no healthcare, no transport, no budget finally. So the question that came to our mind was, if such is the case, and such is the entire chain of one child dying, will only a total political revolution, as possibly Marxist or communist believe, would save these children? Complete eradication of poverty, which we cannot do possibly in our lifetime. We felt that we have another principle to bank on. Principle used by General Montgomery in Second World War. The principle was, strength of a chain is equal to the weakest link in the chain. So if you really need to solve a problem, you don't need to solve every single contributory factor to the problem. You can find out the weakest link where you also have strength, try to solve it, and you can solve the problem. So we decided we need to do something where there are no X-rays and stethoscope. We must do something to diagnose pneumonia in children and save these children. So we designed a simple apparatus called breath apparatus. You can see that. A 1 minute counter, like an abacus. The traditional birth attendant would use it. She would use the breath apparatus to measure the respiratory rate of a child. And fortunately, Vincent Shan, an Australian physician, had found that the respiratory rate of a child is a very good indicator of whether the child has pneumonia or not. So our job became very easy. Measure respiratory rate of every child in the community who has some problem, accordingly diagnose and treat with a very simple antibiotic called cotrimaxazole, very cheap and been there for almost 55 years. And this had dramatic effect on the infant mortality in Gadchiroli. Whereas it was 121 when we started our work in 1988, it came down by 40 to 80 by 1991. This was published as a trial. And very incidentally, if you can look at this data, the effect not only remained till 1991, the case fatality, the deaths in the number of children treated, remained continuously less than 0.1 for past 22 years. This is the largest community-based program for childhood pneumonia management in the world, continued for past 22 years. Published in the Lancet again as a paper, which led to the International Conference on Pneumonia in Children in Washington in 1993, which launched the Global Program of Pneumonia Management in 77 countries. One simple field trial in few villages in Gadchiroli led to a global program in 77 countries. And then we faced our next bottleneck. The IMR of 80 in Gadchiroli in 1990-91, the majority of it was contributed by neonatal mortality, the NMR, almost 62. And what was the neonatal care gap? We found that 54% of the newborns who are born in the community require some kind of medical attention, whereas only 2.6% were seen by a doctor and only 4.4% were actually hospitalized. So huge neonatal care gap in the villages. And such same is the case with India currently, where we have an NMR of 30, almost 8 lakh newborn deaths every year, and 70% of India's IMR is basically neonatal mortality. And where is this newborn? When this photo was taken, the cow had delivered outside and a mother had delivered inside. So such as the state of the labor rooms in the villages, a newborn can be in this condition without any clothes, very close to that floor covered with cow dung, very close to bacteria, can fall sick of hypothermia. So abysmal methods of newborn care per se in the community. And the standard model of newborn care recommended by UNICEF, WHO all across the world was newborn specialized care unit, which were unfortunately inaccessible. The nearest such was 200 kilometers from the headquarter of Gadchiroli. In fact, in 1988, the child of the CEO of the district, who is actually head of the entire healthcare system, died because of pneumonia in childhood. Such was the state of healthcare in the community. Very costly, as we can imagine. Parents were unwilling. If a newborn has to be taken to the hospital, the mother has to go, which means one more lady has to go, which means the father has to go, which means basically the entire family goes. So who will take care of the remaining 3 children, 2 bullocks, 4 cows, 3 goats, and the paddy cultivation? So parents unwilling. And finally, for this 8 lakh newborn deaths and 1.3 crore newborn who require medical attention, we don't have enough neonatologists and beds in the country. So we thought that what about those who can't reach hospital? The effective solution must be community-based, available at home, protect against the main causes of neonatal deaths, and must be low cost. And so we followed another principle. Now this was a principle worth emulating from China. In the first People's Health Assembly of China, after Mao came into power in 1951, how far a mother on foot can walk with a sick baby in her arms, healthcare must be available within that distance. Basically, it means within the village itself, directly. So we asked ourselves, can we outsource newborn care to the villages? And came with a new program, home-based newborn care, with the goal to reduce neonatal mortality by developing a low-cost, home-based model of primary newborn care by using the human potential in villages. And went ahead with selection of a new cadre called community health worker, Arogya Dut, similar to the ASHA, which is currently functional across India. Semi-literate woman, this is Kajubai Undirwade. Her husband, as husbands are in villages, was a drunkard and finally died. And she was left to look after herself, but had the fire in her belly to do something for her community. And 39 such community health workers were selected to begin the program. We found that the primary causes of neonatal mortality in Gadchiroli were sepsis, the biggest cause, infection basically, 52%, birth asphyxia, prematurity, and hypothermia. So we desired that the program must address all these major killer of neonates in the community. So designed a systematic training manual for training the community health workers and went ahead with the training program. Training the community health workers how to use Ambu bag in the case of birth asphyxia for the resuscitation of the newborn, how to use injection gentamicin for treatment of neonatal sepsis, how to measure blood pressure in the case of mother for PIH, how to do urine testing of the mother for urinary tract infection, again PIH, gestational diabetes. And then we invited a panel of top 10 pediatricians, neonatologists from the country to come and evaluate this community health workers before we actually launched the program in the community. The man in turban, Dr. Mehrban Singh, whose textbook for neonatology pediatrics is sort of must for every medical student. The other fellow, Dr. Ramesh Podda, one of the senior most pediatricians from Bombay working in BKC currently. 10 such pediatricians, neonatologists came to Gadchiroli, evaluated this semi-literate community health workers over 3 days. The passing percentage was 70%. In medical college, it is 50%. So higher cutoff was kept for this community health worker. At the end of the evaluation of 3 days, a 3 days exam by external. Imagine what happens when we give one exam to one external. And at the end of the evaluation period, Dr. Mehrban Singh made this statement. These ordinary looking women, the trained CHWs in Gadchiroli, know about newborn care more than the medical graduates of the All India Institute of Medical Sciences. And with this ringing endorsement, we went ahead with implementing the program in the community. So home visits, measuring temperature of the newborn, measuring weight of the newborn, hand washing, breastfeeding support, how to wrap premature low birth baby in blankets, giving proper thermal care, prevent hypothermia, how to do health education, group health education in proper thermal care, how to measure, again, measurement of blood pressure of mothers, newborn care, and finally, treatment of neonatal sepsis by giving injection gentamicin. She was supported with proper supplies, stocks, every regular process, and a supervisor would evaluate and support her by visiting her once every 15 days to evaluate the quality of the work and also to motivate her, solve any problems, and calculate her remuneration, which was completely performance-based. At the end of the trial, and subsequently as we continued the program, there was dramatic reduction in newborn mortality. The upper line is in the control, observation villages where the program was not, and where we were intervening, the NMR neonatal mortality steeply declined from 62 to almost 25. And consistently over past 10 years, it is now hovering between 20 to 25. And the IMR 121 in way back in 1988 came down to 30, which is incidentally the national goal of Government of India under the Millennium Development Goal for India, which one of the poorest district of India achieved before rest of the India almost 10 years back. Well, India hasn't still achieved it, maybe will not achieve it for next 5 years. So, almost 75% reduction in NMR and infant mortality with home-based newborn care, published again as paper in the Lancet, the Journal of Perinatology, and Lancet selected it as one of the best papers in the history of medical science since 1823, and published it as a special volume. This is the only paper from India, is the paper from home-based newborn care. Fortunately, we have such stalwarts such as Ronald Ross, Joseph Lister and Florence Nightingale and Robert Koch and Louis Pasteur in this vintage Lancet volume. So scientifically accepted across the globe, and Time magazine celebrated Search's success as one of the 18 global heroes of health. Incorporated in the 11th and 12th five-year plan of India as the main strategy to reduce IMR in India, the Government of India, Ministry of Health came out with operational guidelines for implementation across the country, and currently home-based newborn care is being scaled up in all the states of India and also Pakistan, Bangladesh, Nepal, multiple African countries with the support of UNICEF, Southeast Asia region. And finally, WHO, UNICEF also, after 20 years, came around and accepted that home-based newborn care must be available to reduce newborn care in the community, and specialized newborn care units are not the only way to save these newborns. Currently, Search is engaged in training state and district and national trainers who would ultimately go and train 8.5 lakh ASHA across the country in implementing home-based newborn care. The next question we had in Gadchiroli, taking just an example, was how to control the social determinants of health. For example, tobacco. A huge problem, you can see, from a child, a little girl, up to women of every age and men are consuming tobacco in Gadchiroli, a silent killer and creeping epidemic. So we did a study and found that the prevalence of tobacco use in Gadchiroli in rural was 55% and in tribal Gadchiroli was 60%, huge burden. And look at the economic cost. We found that Gadchiroli district was consuming tobacco worth 73 crore rupees every year, which was twice, as you can see, the budget of NREGA plus ICDS plus NRHM. In fact, when we worked with the women of the self-help groups, we found they were consuming more tobacco than they were actually saving. So again, this was published as a major paper in Economic and Political Weekly and led to one of the key architects of the tobacco prevention control, Gutkha Prevention Bill in Maharashtra, and currently working on large community mobilization in Gadchiroli district as a district campaign for regulation, working with Women's Network and Tobacco Free Children. Of course, the next question that we faced in search was how to create more such change makers who can take the program, look at the social challenges. So Nirman, a program for youth for purpose of life was launched with almost 30 other social organizations in Maharashtra. And the idea is to begin with knowing self through various scans, experimental understanding of the life and problems of people, understand various approaches for problem solving, and finally take the next step of how can I myself contribute to solving social change. More than 1,000 youth have passed through this process of Nirman in Gadchiroli and trying to become social change maker. To summarize, I think one of the biggest learning of search was this famous saying, act locally and think globally. So combine healthcare with research and the impact can be changed in national and global policy. More poetically, Archimedes put this almost 2,000 years back. He said, O king, give me a liver long enough and a place to stand outside the earth, and I promise you to move the earth. People laughed at him at that time, but now we know by the principle of liver that Archimedes was absolutely correct. That is the power of research. So the work in Gadchiroli as a liver can move and shape the policies in Mumbai, Delhi, Geneva, and Washington. And learning too was how to work with the people. So these five parameters are something which we diligently follow in search. People should need it, people should understand it, people should participate in doing it, people should use it, and people should own it. Again, put more poetically by this beautiful Chinese poem, something again to learn from China, go to the people, live among them, love them, learn from them, listen to them, begin with what they know and build upon what they have. I began with Gandhi, let me end with Mahatma Gandhi. Now, this is a famous saying, I shall give you a talisman. Said when at the partition of India, a youth had approached Gandhiji in Calcutta, when Calcutta was being rocked by partition riots, and asked, how should I choose my path? And the Mahatma told, I shall give you a talisman. When faced with a dilemma as to what your next step should be, bring before your eyes the most wretched and vulnerable human being you ever saw, and ask yourself whether the step you contemplate will help him and will it empower him. The tribal, the women and children of Gadchiroli are our social talisman. Thank you.